to discuss the various kinds of shutters and surfaces that can be used in modular kitchen. The most commonly used and highly used one are the laminates. They vary from various thicknesses of 0.7 mm to 1 mm. They sometimes go to 2 mm also. They come in various kinds of finishes. Some of the best brands are Merino and Greenlamb. They provide very great quality laminates, which are very durable. They have various finishes as well as texture options so that you can feel the graininess of an actual wood on their membrane. It adds to the overall feel of the shutters that you take. They also provide you with high gloss range, which is basically high gloss colored and other finishes in which the gloss level is high and the reflection is very beautiful. The gloss level is not too high or like too great, not too alluring, but it still works well in most kitchens. The best pros of the laminate shutters is that they are affordable, they are great to touch at, they are highly durable as well as scratch resistant material. The gloss level is decent, though not very high and alluring. They are also one of the most versatile products in the market. They are available in n number of ranges. You can make a lot of designs out of it, which actually comes up to be the great option if you want to make something unique yet affordable. So that's why it's the most highly used product in the industry. Some of the cons are that it's not exactly a very premium product. The gloss level, the reflective level is not super high, and that's why they're not generally used in high-end kitchens a lot also. Second finish we're going to talk about is the UV shutter finishes. Now, this is actually the most confusing finish if one thinks about it. They are painted panels. They are huge panels which are painted and then UV coated to make sure that the color does not fade away by excessive exposure to the sun. They are great material in the terms of gloss that they say. Their gloss is very good. Their reflection is not as high as acrylic sheets. They have blurriness within them, which is also called the orange peel effect in our industry. And that's why they are actually a little bit more pricier than laminates, but still cheaper than acrylic in most cases. They have reasonably well amount of ranges. They have good finishes. They have decent amount of patterns, which also have good reflections. So they provide a very good alternative to make a premium yet affordable kitchen. Generally, we don't suggest these kind of panels in a modular kitchen because they are painted and the paint layer is generally not as thick as 1 mm or 0.8 mm also. Due to which, due to accidents in the kitchen, they get damaged a bit too easily. So that's why you don't suggest it in kitchens, but in interiors like wardrobes, LCD panels, other places, they can be used excessively and they offer great quality product that one should use and designers should use it as well. The best product in this range we suggest is the Glossmeister by Merino Laminates. This is a very great, these are very great panel ranges that they have. They have very good UV protection, the gloss level is very high, and the reflection is also very decent if you compare it to other UV panels. The third type of shutters that we're going to talk about are the acrylic shutters. These are the ones that we generally recommend for a modular kitchen. They are 1 mm thick sheets generally of acrylic, which have great reflection and amazing gloss finish to it. They generally do not have a lot of colors or a lot of variety available in them, but still the range is growing day by day. These are very durable and most of them are able to survive the test of time in a kitchen as the sunlight keeps on hitting them, but they do not lose their gloss or change their colors. It used to be the case earlier on, but now they have done a very good job of making sure that that thing does not happen. And because they are 1 mm thick sheets, they make sure that the basic wear and tear of the modular kitchen, they survive in a very well way. The pros are generally that it is highly durable, the gloss level is very great. One can make a very premium looking kitchen from them. The kitchen looks very inviting and sleek, as well as it gives a contemporary look to your entire kitchen. It can also be used very well in wardrobes and LCD panels and still give an amazing look to it. The negatives are that it's a little expensive, somewhat costly as compared to laminates, but it's well worth the change in price. The next finish we are going to talk about is the membrane finish. Now, this is really an old finish. I don't think it's very popular nowadays. It's a little cheap finish, which basically uses post-form technique in which a 0.3 mm sheet is pasted upon MDFs. This is, some people still keep on using it. They have good options and good varieties in it. I don't feel that it's a very durable product because the thickness is a bit too less for my taste, especially for kitchens as well as in other areas also. So the pros are that it can be seamlessly molded onto a shutter. It does not give that edge bending lining, so people can have various designs on MDF and then paste these sheets onto them. It gives a decently good look. The negatives are that it is not generally that heat resistant, and that's why I do not suggest it in kitchens as well. And it is also a little flammable. Again, that's why I'm not recommended for kitchens mostly. 3 mm thickness makes it a bit too thin of a material, and if it gets damaged, it gets damaged easily in a basic wear and tear also. Generally, it also doesn't last very long, this membrane finish. What happens is that it starts to peel off from the MDF if not a very good post-forming technique has been used on it, and sadly that happens quite a few times. Another finish that we're going to talk about is the PU paint, which is also called as lacquer paint. It is a very premium quality shutters because the gloss level is very high. It also provides for seamless corners. It's generally used on good quality MDF and HDF boards. The good point is that it is a very versatile product. It provides with n number of color options to it. It has a lot of different paint artistic effects that one can give it. So one can even nowadays have leather finish, they have hammer tones, n number of beautiful finishes to make sure that the shutter turns out to be a piece of art. And people actually use it very well. These are mostly used in, I would suggest that they are basically used in wardrobes, specifically huge wardrobes that you have in your rooms, as well as LCD panels. In kitchens also they do wonders. And a lot of people use it, and I would recommend its use also. The only drawback is sometimes that it's paint, and the paint coat is not too thick. It can't be as thick as 1 mm or even 0.7 mm. Due to which, if the kitchen is handled in a rough way, if you are dropping a lot of stuff on your shutters, specifically utensils, they might get damaged, and it would be hard to repair them. Good point is they can actually be repaired. You can add another coat on it if you want to later on. Overall, this is a very premium finish. It's generally very expensive, but it gives a very great look to your kitchen. And it's not that durable if you're going to use the kitchen in a rough and tough way. But otherwise, it works well. It has a great life. It does not lose its color. That's why it's also a little expensive. Some of the pros of the PU paint are that it provides seamless edging, great look, makes the shutter look like an artist's work, and gives a good gloss factor. Some of the negatives are that it's actually on the higher end of the budget. It's an expensive finish, as well as it's a little flammable. That's why it's not like the best option for a modular kitchen if one can go for it. And yeah, the durability of it is not that high. If you're going to use your kitchen in a very rough and tough way, it might get dented easily because it's not that thick, and that might cost you a pretty penny to get it repaired. Fortunately though, you can get it repaired. It can be easily reported. Another item to talk about are the veneer shutters. Now, these are actual wood skins that are pasted upon MDF and HDF boards and stained and painted beautifully to bring out the rich and elegant look of the nature. This has great touch to it, the look is very rich, and these are natural products.
So a lot of the, if you come across a unique veneer design, the probability is you're not going to find it later on. Where it's really hard to get again the same kind of veneer with the similar design, with the similar knots to it. Yeah, these are generally preferred by architects a lot in interiors of hotels and rich residences. Pros of this product is that it's a very long lasting, very rich look. It's a little expensive, unfortunately, because of the natural product. As well as one can make it in various forms as well. One can have it in open grain finishes in which you are able to touch and feel the grains of the wood skin. Or one can actually add a layer of gloss on it so that it gives a smooth finish. We suggest a layer of gloss most of the time to be used in kitchens at least. And one can use both the open grains as well as the gloss finish in other parts of the interior. They work well, they look great, and they are used very well as dining tabletops as well.
Thank you for watching the videos, guys. If you like it, do subscribe, share it with other people who are making their homes, who you feel require this information to make a good modular kitchen, and it might help them with their interiors that they'll be doing. You can find all the information that we've said in a blog format right below. Visit our website for more information. You can go to our Facebook page where you can see the kinds of work that we've done and various services that we offer. And do comment and share. Thank you.